Well, my most memorable story of Derek was I went on one of my induction visits to AI, and he took me to Nigeria, was one of the stops on the road, which he knew very well, and he took me to see the Minister of Power at the Ministry of Power in Nigeria, in Abuja, which is one of the great cultural cities of the world. And we went and we did the customary thing. We had a meeting arranged for 2:30 in the afternoon. And at about 7 o'clock in the evening, we were told that the minister would see us now. And having passed 3.5 hours in peaceful chit-chat with Derek, as we went into the minister's drawing room, there were some leather sofas there. And as the minister came in from one end and I went in from the other, and I walked forward, my arm extended to shake his hand, I heard Derek whisper in my ear that one of his relations had died after sitting on a leather sofa in Nigeria, and a large worm had come up through the bottom of the sofa into his or her bottom. This was not an ideal start to an interview with a Minister of State, and I only just managed to keep my giggles under control for the remaining 1 hour.
Well, there have been a lot of stories over 20 years. I think, and it really doesn't have much to do with Aggreko, but I think it epitomizes Derek's competitiveness. I believe there was a Salveson conference probably 12 or 14 years ago, and Derek was a runner and I was a runner. And so the two of us decided to have a run at about 7:30 in the morning. And I'm not the least bit competitive, and Derek is very competitive. We went out on a run, only to come back in a full sprint, trying to beat the other to the back fence of the establishment. So it was quite an interesting run. It was. We didn't run again after that, I can tell you.
My first memory of Derek, in fact, the first time I saw him, was at a dinner I was invited to. This was when I was offered the job in Aggreko, selected by Henrik Jan Molina, and then I got a call to say that Derek's in town, and would I like to join them for dinner. So I turned up at this restaurant, and we had a great dinner, but it was also about the phone calls which were going on through the dinner, through late into the night, about a job being set up, installed in Saudi Arabia. And I saw two aspects of Aggreko in that. One, 24/7 commitment to the customer, but also Derek there being very conscious of the team which are putting in an effort to put the job up in time for the customer and wanting to make sure that the effort was being recognized and would be rewarded at the end of that. That's my first memory of Derek.
Taking my interview. That was the first experience I had with Mr. Shepherd, and that was the first time I met him. It started in 2000, over here in Jebel Ali, and now it's been 10 years now. I mean, next year is going to be 10 years. I wish he was here to give my 10 years award. And I know he's leaving in April, so I'm going to miss him a lot, definitely. I like his way of working. He is straightforward, honest, and he won't beat around the bush. That's what I like. Working for Mr. Shepherd, and he sees where's justice, you know, and that's why I like him that way. It's fantastic working for Aggreko here. Yeah? I find it's like a family-oriented thing. You know, you have your exceptional people, but rest of everyone's perfect. Lovely to work for. This is a big family. And what I like about Mr. Shepherd that he appreciates the work, what I do. He doesn't say it in much words, but I know he does. And he involves me in many ways as well. That's what I like about that. He's a fantastic man. I think he is a good director. I will miss him a lot. I don't know, I wish he could be here for more years to come. And I wish him all the best, his health, his wife, for his family, for his wife, everybody. Wish him best. God bless.
If I ruled the world, every day would be the first day of spring. Every heart would have a new song to sing, and we'd sing of the joy every morning would bring.
If I ruled the world, every man would say the world was his friend. There'd be happiness that no man could end. No, my friend, not if I ruled the world. They do as I fucking said. Every head would be held up high. No, the lights are back. There'd be sunshine in everyone's sky.
It goes back to about 1993, and I think it was a phone call when I was a struggling young new member of Aggreko Australia, and looking for a bit of fleet and a bit of assistance from a more experienced, wily old guy. And Derek was managing Europe at the time, and he very graciously offered me quite a number of canopy sets, which helped our business, and we took them. And my first memory was when I saw them arrive in Melbourne and I realised what European rust looked like. Where did it all start for me? With Derek. It really started after travelling to the UK armed with a number of pictures and an invoice for those lovely canopy sets that he bestowed upon the Australian business. And to his credit, against a lot of challenges from David York and Bill Black in those days, they said, you'll never get him to pay. And to his credit, he looked at it and said, yeah, you're right. I'll be dealing with who sent those.
Summing up working with Derek is very hard. You know, Derek is one of the most driven, one of the most successful, one of the quietest, shyest, retiring men I've ever come across. I'm down in Sri Lanka with Paddy and Derek, and we'd been chauffeured around in this car all day. We came out of a restaurant and we found a tuk-tuk. And Derek said, we'll race you. So Paddy and I jumped into the tuk-tuk, Derek in the back of his Mercedes car, and we raced back to the hotel, and both cars were just doing like, both the car and the tuk-tuk were doing this, and then Derek, absolutely, instead of giving way to let us in, roared in just in front of us to beat us. That summed him up wonderfully from a competitive point of view, but also great fun. There's only one Derek Shepherd.
Right, that was 13 years ago. And Derek sitting in a meeting with Lamnalco, Derek and Henrikian, I think. And Derek going and saying, he was all about, in the meeting, it was all about, we want to do this much business, we want to deliver millions, and we want to take care of our people. And that was something that struck me, I think. And what I said to myself is, wow, that's the company I would want to work with. I was working with Lamnalco at that time, so I was in the meeting representing Lamnalco, and I said, I want to work for Aggreko because they're concerned about people and they're go-getters. Aggreko did not exist as a company, and I was working with the agent 13 years ago. Yeah. I have so many words, but one that comes to mind is expect the unexpected.
Derek, you've done a great job. Nobody can imagine what a contribution you have made to the growth and the prosperity of Aggreko. I'd like to say have a long and happy retirement, but I think what I should say is have a long and happy career after Aggreko, because as sure as hell you ain't going to stop now.
Thank you. We've had our ups and downs. It's been incredibly interesting and rewarding. I've learnt a great, great deal from you. You've contributed a huge amount to Aggreko, and thank you for what you've not only done for the business, but thank you for what you've done for so many people within Aggreko.
Mr. Bar, I would like to thank you very much for all the support, for the last 10 years. You've been very generous and kind. Whenever I walk in your office, I've been regularly walking in your office, and I have been given a welcome with a smile on my face. I'm very, very thankful, and you've been very supporting to us. If you had any problem, we walk into you and you have sorted it out. Thank you very much. I wish you all the best and good luck.
Derek, I know life is about leaving an impact, making a difference. You read about that and people say that, you know what I mean. You have really made a difference, made an impact on my life, my family's life, and the people around me in Aggreko. You've not only made an impact, you've left a big imprint on all our lives. You've changed us as people. You've given us strength of character, and you've added to what we are as people. So we are very different people because of you, and we'll take that. And I guess the tribute we can pay to you is to carry that legacy of what you are about: commitment, hard work, having fun while doing a great job, and being very focused on results. At the same time, you know, not losing the personal touch with people, whether it's family, friends, or work colleagues. Thank you so much, Derek, for that. Thank you.
Derek, you've been fantastic to work with over the last 8 years. Very few people in their lives develop a business from $10 million to $1 billion. What you've done with your people, your leadership, their loyalty to you, and what you've done for Aggreko is fantastic. Have a wonderful retirement.